Hi, I'm Dr. Watt, the healthy neurosurgeon. Today I'd like to clear up a little confusion between what's a probiotic versus what's a prebiotic. Probiotics are the bacteria that are supposed to be living in your gut, primarily in your colon. Now, having bacteria living in your colon may not sound appetizing, but that's very important for your health. They not only serve functions in helping you digest your food and absorb nutrients, but they produce a lot of very important chemicals, things like serotonin, which is a neurotransmitter. So the health of the probiotic, the bacteria in your gut, has a major effect on things like your mental health, depression. It affects your immune system. It can help you fight cancer. So you want to have healthy probiotic bacteria in your gut. Now, just like you feed yourself, you need to feed these bacteria. And prebiotics are the fiber that you can basically think of as the fertilizer or the food for the probiotic. Prebiotics are non-digestible fiber. You don't want your stomach breaking it down. But fibers that in turn can be fermented by the bacteria in your colon to serve as the food for these healthy bacteria. You can buy prebiotics in pills and chewable tablets. There's all kinds of them out there, and every manufacturer will tell you their brand is the best because they want you to buy their brand. But you can actually get a lot of healthy prebiotics just by consuming foods rich in them. Top of the list is asparagus, and raw is best because, again, you don't want the fibers broken down. I'm not a big fan of overcooking vegetables anyway, but for prebiotic content, raw is always better. Now, if you can't tolerate raw asparagus, just lightly steam it for 2 or 3 minutes, but keep it nice and crispy. That crispy crunch is what lets you know the fiber's still there to feed the healthy bacteria. Green bananas, unripened bananas, are also a good source of prebiotic fiber. Now, again, I'm not a big fan of bananas. Tropical fruits are high in sugar, and I want you to avoid sugar as much as possible. But the unripened bananas are actually a little lower in sugar content, and they've got a huge amount of prebiotics. So if you're taking it occasionally in small amounts, not necessarily a bad choice. Crushed garlic is an excellent source. Now I'm talking real garlic cloves, freshly crushed or shredded up, not the powdered garlic that you get in the spice aisle. Dandelion greens can be a fun choice for your salad, and those again are very high in prebiotic fiber. Jerusalem artichokes aren't really artichokes, they're sunchokes, and again, full of prebiotic fiber, really good for you. They're tastier cooked, but again, raw is better. So from a prebiotic perspective, peel them, shred them, or slice them up, grate them even. You can put it on a salad as an accent. Pretty tasty, good source of fiber. Onions are a good source of prebiotic fiber. Sauerkraut is a great option for prebiotic fiber. And a lot of pickles are high in prebiotics, but remember to be a label reader. A lot of pickles come full of high fructose corn syrup, and we want to avoid that like the plague. So, if you want to be healthy, you need to have healthy gut bacteria. If you want healthy gut bacteria, you have to feed them prebiotics. It's not brain surgery.